एवरीवन, वेलकम टू कृषि जागरण बिजनेस। दिस इज यश सक्सेना। यू आर वाचिंग टॉप एग्री बिजनेस न्यूज। लेट्स टेक अ लुक एट टुडेज न्यूज हेडलाइन। प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी टू डेडिकेट 600 मेगावाट केमांग हाइड्रो पावर स्टेशन टू द नेशन। ह्यूमन राइट्स बॉडी आस्क्स दिल्ली एनसीआर गवर्नमेंट टू गिव फ्री टूल्स टू फार्मर्स टू प्रिवेंट स्टबल बर्निंग। यूनियन फर्टिलाइजर मिनिस्ट्री में सीक फर्टिलाइजर सब्सिडी ऑफ रुपीज 2.25 ट्रिलियन फॉर फाइनेंशियल ईयर 24। सेंटर डिनाइज रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ शॉर्टेज ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर्स इन रबी सीजन, सेज देयर इज इनफ सप्लाई। द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल साइंसेज होल्ड्स अ सेमिनार ऑन रीजनरेटिव एग्रीकल्चर। इंडिया इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड फेयर ओपन्स फॉर द पब्लिक। इफको एमसी कंडक्ट्स फार्मर मीटिंग एट सोनावरी रायगंज। All India Rubber Industries Association urges government to help natural rubber producers get better prices. Maharashtra government decides to provide financial aid to farmers for crop damage. Odisha bets on underground pipeline based irrigation system for climate proof farming. KT Kama Rao asks veg oil industry to invest in Telangana. Crude palm oil prices might witness a rise of 8-10% as a result of growing demands. With no consensus reached, COP27 gets extended by a day. Oil meal exports witnessed an increase of 38% during the April-October period this year. As winter step in, New Delhi witnesses a bright sunny weather. In an effort to launch connectivity and energy infrastructure project in Arunachal Pradesh, Prime Minister Narendra Modi dedicated a 600 megawatt Kemang hydro power station to the nation, which was developed at a cost of more than ₹8,450 crore. Kemang Hydropower Station is the run-of-the-river scheme to harness the hydropower of the Bishom and Tenga rivers, both tributaries of the river Kemang. With the powerhouse located at Kimi, West Kemang District, Arunachal Pradesh, the power station has two dams, one at Bishom and other at the Tenga. The Prime Minister also inaugurated the first greenfield airport, Donyi Polo, in Arunachal Pradesh, Itanagar. The name of the Donyi Polo Airport reflects people's reverence from Sun Donyi and Moon Polo to symbolize the state's culture and heritage. The National Human Rights Commission held a third round of meeting on Friday through a video conferencing with the chief secretaries of Delhi, Haryana, Punjab and Uttar Pradesh and asked them to give a detailed report on how to prevent air pollution in Delhi NCR region. The meeting was held with the chief secretaries of four states through a video conferencing under the chairmanship of NHRC Chairman Justice Arun Kumar Mishra regarding air pollution, as the national capital and the NCR region continues to be covered with a heavy blanket of smog. In the last hearing, the chief secretaries of the Punjab, Haryana, Delhi and Uttar Pradesh were summoned to control air pollution in Delhi NCR. The commission reprimanded the governments of four states, holding them responsible for poor management of stubble burning after hearing the version of the chief secretaries of the respective states. National capital and the NCR region continues to be covered with a heavy blanket of smog. In the last hearing, the chief secretaries of the Punjab, Haryana, Delhi and Uttar Pradesh were summoned to control air pollution in Delhi NCR. The commission reprimanded the governments of four states, holding them responsible for poor management of stubble burning after hearing the version of the chief secretaries of the respective states. The Union Fertilizer Ministry is likely to seek a subsidy on soil nutrients of around 2.25 trillion rupees for the next fiscal year, which would be roughly the same level as the expenses to be incurred to subsidize the retail prices of these farming inputs in 2022-23, against the budget estimate of ₹1.05 trillion for 2022-23. The fertilizer subsidy is expected to be revised upward by more than 114% to ₹2.25 trillion this fiscal year, as elevated global prices of fertilizers and natural gas, the key feedstock, have inflated cost. Center on Friday said that there is adequate availability of key fertilizers, including urea and DAP, in the country for the ongoing Rabi season, and has rejected the reports of shortages in Tamil Nadu and Rajasthan. According to the Fertilizer Ministry, the pro rata requirement of urea was approximately 57 lakh tons up to November 14, against which the government has ensured the availability of approximately 92 lakh tons. The sales of urea have been reported at around 38 lakh tons, it is said. In the case of D-ammonia phosphate, the ministry has said the requirement was approximately 28 lakhs ton, against which approximately 36 lakh tons were made available. The University of Agricultural Sciences, in association with Bharatiya Kisan Sangh, is organizing a two-day national seminar on regenerative agriculture under changing climatic scenarios in peninsular India on Saturday and Sunday at the Farmers Knowledge Center on the UAS campus. Adrishya Kada Devraswamy of the Kaneri Mutt in Kolhapur opened the seminar today at 10 a.m. Former Vice Chancellor of Kamdhenu University, Gandhinagar and Anand Agriculture University, Gujarat, Dr. M.C. Varshneya, was the chief guest at the event. Rural Development Minister Giriraj Singh inaugurated the Fair of Saras Ajivika Mela 2022. About 300 seva group women from all over the country participated in the fair. The event focused on empowering people and motivating them to become financially stable. The India Trade International Fair has also opened for the public. With this year, the grand event has over 2,500 exhibitors from 29 states, UTs and 14 countries. The product of almost 2,500 domestic and international exhibitors, including those from the UK and the UAE, will be put on display this year. Krishi Jagran's team also covered the much-awaited events. Let's have a look at it. Yesterday, IFFCO MC conducted a farmer meeting at Sonabari, Raiganj. At the event, they discussed and promoted the usage of farmer products Yutori, Atari, Humetsu, Aniki, Igao, etc. More than 115 farmers participated in the event. The All India Rubber Industries Association President Ramesh Kejriwal has asked the central government to help the natural rubber producers get better prices while cutting the import duties on the industrial raw material. Besides, allowing shipments into all ports in the country. The association demanded that the center set a benchmark price that will encourage rubber growers to produce more rubber. The Maharashtra government on Thursday approved the proposal to provide financial aid to farmers whose crop have been damaged in rainfall between September to October. Approximately 13 lakh farmers have been identified as beneficiaries from Aurangabad, Jalna, Hingoli, Parbhani, Nanded, Bid, Latur, Pune, Satara and Solapur. The Maharashtra Revenue Department on Thursday issued a resolution to the effect sanctioning a total of approximately ₹1200 crores as an aid to the farmers. The sum will not be used for the beneficiaries who have already been identified by the government for financial aid for crop damage due to rainfall in July and August. The government will give a financial aid up to ₹13,600 per hectare for cultivated land, ₹27,000 per hectare for horticultural land and ₹36,000 per perennial land. The Odisha government has begun adopting the underground pipeline-based irrigation system as a part of its efforts to encourage the climate-proof agriculture that will be environment-friendly. The state has taken a step ahead by launching a pressurized irrigation system that can help farmers to adopt drip irrigation without secondary pumping. The pipeline-based irrigation system, which was launched in 2017, helps in the efficient use of the water and crop diversification. The state has completed over 3.5 lakh hectares of such a system, with the total area likely to increase to 4 lakh hectares, with the state government emphasizing crop diversification. Telangana Industries and IT Minister K.T. Kamarao has urged the vegetable oil industry to invest in Telangana. According to a statement released, the minister has said that they have targeted to grow oil palm on 20 lakh acres in the next 5 years. He said that they are also promoting food processing zones and hence invited the oil industry to invest in Telangana. Addressing a global roundtable organized by the Indian Vegetable Oil Producers Association in Hyderabad, he promised to offer a tailor-made incentive for those willing to invest in the state. Telangana Agriculture Minister S. Niranjan Reddy said that the state was targeting to cover 1.75 lakh acres under the oil palm plantations this year. He also said that heavy rains have disrupted the place, but the state will most likely achieve its target by February next year. Crude palm oil prices, which have seen a huge volatility in the last 6 months, are expected to go up by 8 to 10% as the demand for staple edible oil grows across the countries. Crude palm prices, which are ruling at around $1,000 a ton, now witnessed a huge fluctuation this year due to geopolitical issues, including the Ukraine-Russia war and Indonesia banning the export of crude palm oil. Ahmad Parvez Ghulam Qadir, the Director General of the Malaysian Palm Oil Board, has suggested India to focus on increasing production in the existing cropping area. With countries unable to arrive at a consensus, the 27th edition of the United Nations Conference of Parties in Sharm el-Sheikh, which was scheduled to end on Friday, has been extended by a day. Union Environment Minister Bhupender Yadav said in a blog late Friday that the COP was supposed to wrap up its work today but has been extended by a day to attempt to take the ongoing negotiations to a logical end. Consensus is key on several issues and the extension is an attempt towards achieving it. As of Friday evening India time, 3.5 hours ahead of Sharm el-Sheikh, Egypt members were still deliberating on a draft agreement that reaffirmed a commitment to the Paris Agreement of 2015. According to the data compiled by the Vegetable Oil Industry Body, the Solvent Extractors Association of India, India's overall oil meal export have witnessed an increase of 38% at around 1.97 million tons during the current financial year from the month of April to October so far. During the same period last fiscal, the export of oil meal was 1.43 million tons. Oil meals are basically the residue left over after the extraction of oil from oil seeds, and they are widely used as livestock feed. New Delhi witnessed bright and sunny weather in most areas of the city. The temperature varied between a moderately hot 25 degrees Celsius and mild 13 degrees Celsius. The highest temperature of 25 degrees Celsius was more in line with the December average maximum of 23.5 degrees Celsius than the average maximum of 28.6 degrees Celsius in November. The city also witnessed a late sunrise at 6:46 a.m. and sunset took place at 5:26 p.m. Now, here is the Agricultural General Knowledge Quiz, where you can win discounted coupons of the FTV Organic, which is Farmer, the brand organic. The question is, National Academy of Agricultural Research and Management, NAARM, NARM, is located at option A, New Delhi, option B, Kolkata, option C, Hyderabad, or option D, Karnal. Do let us know your answers on the number 8800023204. We will wait for your answers. Till then, keep watching Krishi Jagran Agribusiness. Thank you. This is Yash Saxena, signing off.